And baby Jeanette, thank you for the sub. What's up, Fexy Magic? What's up, sweetie? Hello from Sweden. Hello from, or rather, Los Angeles, Fexu in Sweden. Welcome, Cuddy McGill. Welcome, Carly, to the Week in Review.
Hello! Hello, friends! So nice to see all of you in chat. Thanks for joining us.
It's so great. I'm still getting used to the fact that I now start this at 4 p.m. my time. Right. What time is it in Sweden right now, Fexu? What's up, Sideshow?
Shout out
to Sideshow again. Enjoyed that track from Friday. Pig Bullets, oh my god, you're here. Pig Bullets gifted 100 subs on Tuesday.
Wow, that's
yeah, it was
so
kind
kind
of amazing. Thank you so much. And what was one of the weirdest streams I've done?
Oh, really?
Man, baby, yeah, Hammer Smash Face 69. Thank you so much for the sub and for the username. Yeah, it was a weird one. Things got a little weird in Among Us. We're all good. Everything is fine. But it definitely was like such a bizarre. I mean, it was heated. You know what I mean? hell yeah, Sideshow. Yes, everything will be a lot less, I think a lot less crazy tomorrow, for sure. And again, thank you, Pig Bullets, for that. Oh, nice, Sideshow, dude. Yeah, for sure. You should definitely do that. There's the Carly emotes.
What happened? I love it. It is as one who has tried to make emotes and I'm working on it. That's actually me.
I mean, that was a pro, you know, I don't even know who did it. That was such a hookup. Yo, thank you so much, Bancho Broly and Picoco 582 for the sub. You're men, baby. Can I still say that in 2021? I don't know. But I do know it's the week in review. I do know I'm sober as a cat, but I'm going to stay sober as a cat. Well, actually, no, this is not true. I do have some legal, so I can talk about it and do it and everything, edible marijuana that I'll be having in a little while. You're not canceled just yet, absolutely. So that's very exciting for the final. So what we're going to do is we've got the lovely Marie coming through in the second hour. We, of course, will be talking about our weeks, speaking towards them in the first hour, and we're going to close out with a little Jackbox, and of course, we'd love to invite you guys in. I think Marie may stay, Lexi may join, so it should be a fun final hour as well, and we thank you all for being here. Without further ado, shall we start, Carly? Carly, first of all, two things are not on the list that probably should be on the list. One personal, one global. Daft Punk broke up today.
Oh.
Did you not know this, Carly?
I did not know. I did not spend much time on Reddit today. I imagine I would have known.
I'm sure Reddit absolutely would have told you. Reddit would have been the first. Of course, Reddit loves nothing more than betting on Wall Street and fucking Daft Punk. And for sure. And people love Daft Punk. I've never been like this massive Daft Punk fan. They've always just been a part of the soundtrack of our fucking lives, but they have.
Yeah,
I enjoy them
fine.
Yeah,
but why'd they break up? Or is there no controversy?
Don't know. Yeah, the publicist, you know, Pitchfork, I think reached out for. They said there was no specific reasoning they've given. I mean, maybe they're just done. You know what I mean? Carly looks adorable. You look like Riveter. Rosie, yeah. Riveter, is that her name?
Sure. Yeah, that works.
What's her name? What's the feminist?
It is. It's Rosie the Riveter. That's right.
Rosie the Riveter. You look like Rosie the Riveter.
I share these secrets because I think it's funny to be truthful about it. I curled half my hair, got bored, so put it in a ponytail, and I curled it because up until this afternoon I have not had water in the barn because all the pipes were frozen. So coming to you dirty, but curled. So.
Yeah, mid to late 50s, just retired. You know, I that makes sense to me. I always say this, though. Well, first of all, not for them, because I think that epilogue thing they did is super fucking cool. But I generally say this. Why retire from music? Do you ever retire from music? I think the whole point of retiring from music is just so that you can have a reunion tour that'll sell a lot of tickets. You know what I mean? Or a farewell tour that'll sell a lot of tickets. You know what I mean? I just think it's so crazy. It's like you're never going to truly retire until you die. It's a life job. You know what I mean?
Well, maybe they're just tired of that project. I mean, who knows? True. Maybe it's all mutual. They want to, like, do different stuff. Who knows?
Somebody said, I believe, made the joke of, like, I wonder whose solo career is going to be bigger, Daft or Punk. Yeah. This just didn't come and retire. That's why we even said, I mean, there's a possibility, you know, we may never play again, but we still set extended hiatus.
Yeah, because if the opportunity came about, you know, there will someday be a visit to LA from this gal. It wouldn't be too hard to get those boys.
Yeah,
it would be great to do a show. But
or we would go to, and we both also, I feel like, owe New York a final goodbye tour personally.
Yeah,
so
too.
I feel like if we just planned that out around the same time, we could do a Kalman show.
Yeah.
So, but either way, so Daft Punk wasn't even in my stories for this week. The other thing that wasn't in my stories is more personal, because it's so boring. So in LA, one of the things when you get an apartment is they just don't have fridges.
Right, right, right.
So one of the problems you have to solve immediately upon moving here is getting a fridge. And we tried to get it as soon as possible. It got delayed. Part of why last week kind of sucked. It got delayed, and fucking, so we're just, like, it's, like, you don't realize how, I mean, you had the same realization recently with plumbing and shit.
Yeah.
You, like, don't realize what you don't have until you don't have a fridge, and we even with a mini fridge was fucking annoying as fuck to, you know, so a big part of we got the fridge in on Saturday, and then we immediately went to Trader Joe's, and we just fucking stocked up so hard. Also, we've had the tiniest, shittiest fridge in New York for so long, so getting this big-ass adult fridge.
Right, that's pretty cool.
Man, baby, JD Panda, thank you for the 5 gifted subs, including 2 Sideshow, Jeruman, Sparkle Fart, Ill Druid, and Chupacabra. Enjoy those emotes. Let's see some fucking Carly emotes in the chat. Man, baby. Or whatever emotes. Who gives a shit? Let's just see them. But either way, just getting that in, and then also not, and like also finally being able, we spent so much money at the grocery store. Man, baby, you have to get the fundamentals when you just move to a place, first of all. But second of all, just going and getting just like so much fucking shit.
Yeah.
Because we finally have the space. It's not like a Tetris puzzle trying to fit our Trader Joe's haul. But I am over going to the grocery store. We've been to the grocery store like 3 days in a row for the past 3 days.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. It's ridiculous.
Aw, thanks, friends.
We keep remembering shit we need, and then all of a sudden we have like a full cart of groceries, and I'm just like, but I think we're finally done. I think we've got it under control. We're good to go. And not interesting enough to put it on my main stories. But definitely needed a mention. Hell yeah, with the page 7 emotes. We got the Carly emotes.
I'm so happy for you getting a big, big kid fridge. Because it's true, you know, and you and Lexi also cook at home often. And
yes.
Here you are dealing with that tiny fridge. Now you got a big kid fridge. You're going to have such an easy time finding, like, where do I put ice cubes?
Man, baby, Square Knot, I need Holden to perform Break On Through by the Doors. Also, I need him to do a little turtle impression. Thank you. All right, so we got animal impressions.
I
changed the cartoon characters for this week, but animal impressions also work. A turtle impression.
I like.
All
right, turtles are like.
And the cool thing about an adult fridge.
Do I get to do a turtle?
I just want to finish this real quick. Okay. The cool thing about the fridge, it really, I've never felt like more of an adult in my life than buying a nice fridge for myself. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not skimping either. Getting a nice fridge. Because
it's
we didn't get to have fun in 2020.
When appliances actually become exciting.
Yes. We didn't get to have any fun in 2020, and we saved as much money as we could in order to do exactly that kind of shit. So it does feel nice to be like, take my money, give me my good fridge. That said, it doesn't have an ice maker or a water dispenser, but whatever, I'm fine with
you
that.
You know what, though? The ice makers always break within the first year. I have never been to somebody's house with an ice maker that worked, or there's some problem with the filter. They're just a broken thing no matter where you go, so fuck it.
Yeah, and it but it does have one of those, it does have the freezer at the bottom, and it's that giant slide-out freezer with, like, that's the big space. Yeah, it's got that, and that was more important to me anyways.
Jesus.
Man, baby. So there you go. Welcome to the stream, everybody. It's going to be a good one. Make your turtle, do your turtle impression for us, please, Carly.
My turtle, okay. Thank you. That is an end scene.
Very good. I like that. I think mine was better, but who's counting?
No, authentic. Did you see my face? Come on.
So I will be performing Break On Through a little bit later in the hour. I want to get through some of our stories first before we bring in Marie. And, of course, those are the incentives tonight. Animal impression or a cartoon character impression for $5. It is animal impression. So there you go. And $10 to choose one of us to perform a karaoke song of your choice. I will be doing Push On Through by the Doors. I haven't done Doors much or ever for karaoke, which is kind of funny because I feel like
that is surprising.
They're so karaokeable.
Yeah, I feel like you're gonna nail it.
The Doors have kind of gone out of style, I feel like, as of late. I feel like it's cooler to like the Stones or like, what, you know what I mean? It's funny. I feel like the Doors are gonna make a big
resurgence. There's still some good Doors tunes, but I think we also got very familiar with the Doors in college, and then what?
Right.
You know, they sort of just faded.
All right. First story. I mean, hey, so the first story of the night is very fun and exciting. It's actually been, Lexi kind of had some issues getting her healthcare up and running and getting established with, because you sing like Jim Morrison. I assume you're better at poetry. I would hope. But either way. What was I going to say? Lexi hasn't been to the baby doctor in a minute. We actually went today. We got up super early to do early for us, which is like 7 in the morning.
Good job.
And then we went all the way out there. And then they told us that I can't come in. And so I just went all the way home and waited. And then she came home later. So I was very mad that I woke up this morning at that time. And I'm drinking this lemonade right now. This iced tea right now to really try to wake up. Apparently it's got caffeine in it.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Because lemonade doesn't have any caffeine, but tea does. No.
This does, though. Yeah. And I'm going to have, I'll have this sativa edible later. But then holding Rose to power and dethrone the Lizard King. Absolutely. But we got new pictures. And I want to talk about kind of where the baby's at. Because I have some information, some tips, and some guides.
Is it a cantaloupe yet?
I'll tell you the exact shape, but there it is. All right, so there you can see the head up top left there, and like the head's top left in both pictures. You see his little arm flappers.
Yeah, he's got flaps.
And the little body and the top. It looks really creepy. It looks like it's creepily Joker smiling at us. We don't know if that's actually the case, but that's what it looks like. It actually did have a tail at one point. That's one of the interesting, funny, gross things you learn about babies is that they actually do have a tail at one point. It's funny you say that, Reagan Piper Rose. The doctor said that too. The doctor said she's perfect. So it's looking really good. She again is hilariously a geriatric pregnancy, she's still got a lot more like tests to go in for, specialists to meet with. There's a lot more to kind of go through to find out where we're at exactly, but this is looking very strong. I'm very excited. She said she was moving around. I mean, it is a rave in there in her uterus right now, apparently.
Yahoo.
So
this is kind of, you know, intimate. We're looking at Lexi's insides.
Yeah, we're looking at Lexi's guts right now. Some babies just want to watch the world burn. Absolutely. Look at her big brain. I know, right? I mean, that looks good to me. And I just love that top left, how it looks like she may just be like actually a supervillain. So, I always knew I had strong swimmers, Sideshow. I mean, when I cut a load out, it is like, you know.
Is that how you know?
Huh?
Is that how you know?
Oh, it's a viscosity of the load. It's like what's that Nintendo game with the ink with the multiplayer game? They just announced a sequel to it. What's the name of the game? You know what it is with the squid kids.
I'm not sure.
With the squid kids. Splatoon. It's like Splatoon.
There you go.
It is just an absolute splatter fest. People think it's just like, you know, thank God it's not red colored, or people would think there was a massacre happening every time I fucking splashed one out, whatever, through pure excitement and sort of sexual.
Your poor socks, you know, maybe back in the day, because obviously you and Lex got it going on.
Fill
but
water
your
balloons.
Socks must have been just tried and tested true.
Unbelievable. But what is believable is that is in the middle of week 14. And real quick, too, I just want to throw this book out here. We're Pregnant. This is really great, especially any of you ladies out there that might have checked out Dads-to-Be. We're Pregnant, the First Time Dad's Pregnancy Handbook, is a really good resource for dads. The only thing I absolutely hate about it is it refers to Lexi as mom, and it refers to the baby as baby. And there's just the way that that is said sometimes makes me like want to throw up. But besides that, it's really good at just breaking down week to week what's going on with your pregnant ass significant other or whatever. Or if you knock someone up at the back of a McDonald's, but you're now kind of strapped to them, you can still find out what's going on with them and how you could help and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, even just saying the baby, I think, would have been better than just baby. So here we go. Here are the stats right now for week 14. Your baby is almost the size of a baseball.
Oh, we're at baseball level. Okay.
Baseball, which is kind of crazy.
I thought we were getting close to cantaloupes. I think Lexi said, like, it'd been a week, should be a cantaloupe. I was like, holy shit.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's
a
crazy.
Massive growth.
Baby's body is lengthening, baseball. Which we can see there. Definitely is very long to me. Baby has a neck, which we can also see there. And its kidneys are functioning. Fine hair called lanugo is developing on baby's body. How about your spawn? It'd be a lot better. F around and find out. Thank you so much for the sub.
Lanugo.
So, yeah.
Hmm.
And, yeah. And mom's uterus is continuing to expand. She's getting less morning sickness. I can tell she's less nauseous. I've seen that.
That's good.
But as reflex is, but apparently she's farting more this week.
Sure.
Apparently she's very farty this week. I haven't experienced that.
Well, because if something
farty.
is in your uterus, it's pushing all the farts out.
Right.
There's no room for farts right now.
And the lanugo, yeah, exactly. So that's gross as well. I called mine my succubus, absolutely. No scales yet. I mean, I can see a tinge of scales there, potentially. But she's almost a week 15, so we might as well say that as well. She'll be week 15 on Thursday.
All right.
Yeah, I fart a lot too, by the way, when I drink IPA. So I'm right there with. I fart so bad, and I got way too drunk on IPA on Friday night because I took a week off from drinking. So I like revolted, drank. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I was also having a weird
rebellious.
Week. Yeah, I was also having a weird week, so I just went for it. And apparently, I was farting up a storm, but I was totally passed out. And like Lexi was just like, "Should I wake him?" And I was just, it was like a blaster all night long on Friday night. But either way. Baby stats. Babies, this is week 15. Baby's lungs, though primitive, are functioning. Mm. Baby's legs are now longer than its arms next week. Your baby's taste buds have begun to develop. So hopefully getting excited for that milk soon. We're hoping. You know, this is a funny thought that we were joking around about. But like, you know, if the baby takes to the nipple or not, it's like you're saving money on food, man, baby. At that point,
for sure.
So you really want the baby to take because then you're not spending extra.
Free food.
Yeah. So I didn't even think about that. Punk Jess, yo, thank you so much for the gifted sub to Panty Pudding 66.
Are y'all doing like a diaper genie? How are you gonna dispose of those baby loads, or is that jumping ahead too far?
We're not quite there yet. I will say we just got in our book. There's actually a book like this for like first year baby. And there's a different book Lexi got us for like what you're to expect with a first year baby. So
I'm so glad you've got these resources. That's really awesome. And, you know, obviously we got friends with kiddos and stuff, but that's great that
it's very, you know, I mean, it's very exciting. Like, especially this is not like super encompassing. I mean, every week I sit with it for 10 minutes and read the next chapter, maybe read the next week after that. But after that, it's like, you know, you put it down and wait.
That is a good question. Squirnaut says, is there a bidet for babies?
I don't think so. But doubtful, I think a normal bidet would probably be fine. I don't even know. That's probably not fine. Probably anything's bad. That's what I've learned. Anything that's for adults is not good. We have a washer, dryer, cloth diapers are great. I mean, we have one for the floor, for our floor, but I don't know if I want to subject our neighbors to that. But we'll be dealing. I mean, we'll be up to our fucking armpits and piss and shit.
When you get the baby wipes and stuff, get the kind that you can put in the toilet that are compostable or whatever.
You know, this is the problem with that, though, man. Those, from everything I've seen, that's all bullshit. From everything I've seen, even the stuff that says you can put it in the toilet,
it's not compostable. Not good.
Yeah, that's what people say. That's what I've learned is that even there you go, Moon.
It's all a lie.
It's all a lie. Like and they cause those giant monsters in your
plumbing. Yeah, what do they call it? I remember reading about that on the train.
There's like a name for it, right?
Like a phlegm ball or something like that. A fat berg. Thank you, Moon Bastard.
Yeah, because the thing is with toilet paper that other stuff can't do. I did get a tushy. The thing with toilet paper that nothing else, it dissolves. Damn. It fully dissolves in water. In fact, that was like a chemistry, and I learned that in chemistry class because it's like a certain chemical. It fully it goes from solid to dissolve totally into liquid. So, you know, it's just going to be a literal shit show over here, but that's fine. But anyways, that's baby update. And that's all I got.
Here I am jumping straight ahead to the shit. I'm like, how are you going to handle all the poop?
So actually your next one is like kind of a little video thing. So let me put this on.
Yeah. So I've got maybe weird stories this week. Well, because we haven't had a straight up week in review in a while. So this is from 2 weeks ago. And, this is Byron here in the video. But one day we just spent the entire day splitting logs. And you have to do that a year before you plan to burn them. And this was like a new experience for me because I'm also look at this machine thing that he's running. Yeah, I looked at that. I'm like, oh, it's so slow, you know, whatever. How nice and convenient to have this machine, the splitter, right? Apparently they're incredibly dangerous. Like the amount of pressure and like air pressure that it's using.
Right.
You can lose fingers, hand, you could like really hurt yourself on one of these things. Meanwhile, I'm watching this dopey dude just like he was all over. I was like, oh, I didn't know. Yeah, I'm very stressed. You shouldn't, I mean, don't be stressed because it's not like it's an axe blade. It's just like a wedge. So my job on this little assembly line was all these logs that are right in front of this video. I was just hauling logs. And it's been so cold in Kansas. This was an incredibly chilly day. But it was really nice to just lift some shit. And this is why it's one of my news stories. It's like, if you have been stuck inside because it's been cold and like, maybe just find some heavy stuff and lift it. And I was like, you know, don't use your back, use your legs and all that. And then I also learned that birch wood, for whatever reason, is so much heavier. I think we're also, some of this is ash, but those birch pieces were like thick. I mean, it was like lifting, you could just feel the density of it. And so I always like sharing these strange stories because I've never been really exposed to what it takes to just have a fire, you know? But you plan like the year ahead because all of this wood now is gonna dry out and age, and you know, next year I'll be ready to burn.
It's also great to do something like that in the cold and then go home and take a nice warm shower and like warm and get all warm after like a day of that. It's so nice too.
I know it's a chore for most, but I really enjoyed it, and so I just wanted to share it with you, you know.
What else?
I'm around a lot of wood, a lot of lumber. So I'm learning so much about lumber. It's crazy.
Do you know where Lawrence is? Do you know where Lawrence is?
Yes, I do. I know where it is, but Jackal I haven't Party been lives anywhere. In
Lawrence.
Who now?
Jackal Party.
Oh, cool.
Manual chores are great in moderation, absolutely. I mean, I just enjoy, you know, I know we've there's the in joke about doing the dishes, but there is something nice about, I feel like, waking up and just doing a couple chores while you're still kind of groggy. You get things done.
Oh, I always do my chores first thing.
Yeah, you get things done, but you,
I get
you're
my
still
coffee.
Just waking up, you know what I mean? One of my favorite memories of childhood was doing wood or like 3 hours, for like 3 hours, my buddy accidentally drinking his dad dip spit out of the Gatorade bottle. Oh, my God.
Oh,
dude.
No.
Hey, I don't think I've ever actually done that. What I've definitely done is taken a big swig of beer out of one that had been ashed in, probably by me, for several cigarettes, for sure. I've definitely done that, but it's not a nice place, says Hammer Smashed. So fantastic.
Yeah, well, Lawrence is kind of a little bit more of a, from what I understand, I'm new to this Kansas world, perhaps a little more liberal, or let's say progressive, because liberal has lots of connotations too. I don't know. But I hear good things about Lawrence, and I think there's some family living there too. So I've heard about it through them.
So next up, we're going to talk about video games. I saw you had a game you wanted to talk about. I love it because yours is like a time capsule video games always, because I think you kind of jump on the sale.
Well, I wait for them to go on sale. Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I'm like, oh, I kind of remember Injustice 2. We'll talk about that in just a second. My game that I wanted to talk about is 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim. 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim is a PlayStation 4 game that came out kind of in the holiday season. It is it might still be on sale for $40 on the Big in Japan sale, and it is just amazing. What's up?
I'm sorry. Pig Bullets did the flooring in a barn in Lawrence. I mean, there's just so many Kansas.
That's so funny.
I love it.
So this is a game. This is a game that's like two games in one. It's like this tower defense game where you're controlling these kids in mechs as they fight giant kaiju. And then it's also an adventure style game where you're like uncovering this plot. There are 13 main characters. There's a time travel mechanic. There's a multiple parallel timeline mechanic. It takes all of these elements, and it definitely is it's clearly in love with all sorts of different anime and things like that. There's a lot of Neon Genesis in here. There's a lot of there's a little nod to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, little things like that. It's so fascinating. Moon Bastard, it's like Into the Breach, but with this amazing adventure story mode connected to the tower defense stuff. And it is so well done. It is, the story is great. Like, to the point where, like, Lexi is finding herself kind of stopping and paying attention because it's just so crazy. There are androids. There are, kids who've lost their memory. There's traveling from 1985 to the 1940s.
Are there aliens?
2065, huh?
Are there any aliens?
Yes, there are aliens. Ooh. There are. It is like really, really, really fucking good. And this was a game that was very much touted by a lot of people as like that game no one played in 2020 that is just maybe the best game of the year. It's just absolutely fantastic. Like, I can't wait to go play more of it tonight. It definitely has me.
And
has
it's
me
running for
in.
40 right now. $40.
I don't know if it's on anything but PS4 either.
Oh, okay.
But I think it's currently still on. I believe that Big in Japan sale is still going on the PlayStation Store. So it is. It is out. On that for $40. But either way, I don't know. Check it out if you like anime. If you like adventure games. If you like. I don't know what. Just a lot of awesome, great storytelling, stuff like that. The tower defense part is very cool. I haven't played it a lot. I'm still trying to, like, I read in a guide somewhere. It was like, take this story mode as far as you can take it and then play the kind of the tower defense mode. And I've been just doing so much story stuff. So I don't even know if I'm actually should be playing the game like that. I'm starting to feel like maybe I should balance it out a little bit more. But the story is so fascinating. And I'm really starting to, like, Like all the characters, obviously, they have different relationships with each other, and their stories are all, like, intertwined. So it's very fun to, like, jump into one person's story, play the next little bit of it, and then... Yeah. Even though you could keep playing their story, because it'll just give you like a little chunk at a time, then you'll get popped out to this main menu. And then you can go, oh, well, I really want to check out this other kid's story that connected to that kid's story now that I know something. Now that I know that they're secretly a robot or something like that. It's called 13 Sentinels, yeah. There's actually
what's the subtitle there?
Aegis Rim. 13 Aegis Sentinels, Rim. Aegis Rim. And there is a, also, there's actually a third mode that is like an archives, but you spend mystery points to like unlock more archives, and you're trying to unlock all of the archives to like not just get the whole story, but it also adds the story progression. It's cool. Just really fucking cool. It's unique. It's got its own vibe. Really great soundtrack. Great, just great, great, weird, weird, great stuff. So that's been my big game as of late. Injustice 2.
Okay, so for any of you who are in my Discord at all, I was like, hey, because there was a really fun Steam sale over the weekend, and it ended today, but it's all anything Bruce Wayne Batman related. So I got 3 Lego Batman games, which is a big deal because all these Lego games are quite popular with a 4-year-old kiddo who hangs out with us here. And I mean, we've almost completed the first Avengers game, like to 100%. I think we're in the high 80 percentile of getting all the characters and all the other stuff. So I got 3 Batman Legos. Awesome. The Lego games are so much fun. They're so hilarious. You know who we found in Avengers last week? Lou Ferrigno, the original Hulk. And when he transforms into the Hulk, Stan Lee comes, he just like sprays himself green. And then he's like regular size, but right. Green. And then Stan Lee comes on when he transforms back and just like sprays him with water and cleans him off. So great.
That's awesome.
I have learned so much about the Marvel universe through Lego. Meanwhile, I've been reading House of X, and now I'm reading Dawn of X. So I'm really getting through all the X-Men and whatnot.
Is Dawn of X like then? I've been actually reading some X-Men as well. Mm-hmm. I read God Loves, Man Kills this past week, and I was actually going to talk about, we're studying WandaVision this week, so I read House of M. Uh-huh. And some of that stuff. So we're going to talk about that later on in the episode.
I haven't gotten, it's very vague what's going on with Scarlet Witch in this series, but I did hear a thing or two that she has done. But yeah, there's overlap there. And then we also just happened to watch one of the later Spider-Man movies, because kiddo also likes Spider-Man. And there's all this overlap. For whatever reason, the fact that I am just inundated happily by superhero stuff, I am becoming quite the aficionado. Like, I'm really starting to get it, and it feels so good. Like, I love, it's so rewarding when you realize how the characters overlap. And yeah, the X-Men, I thought about bringing it up again, but I didn't. Instead, I did Injustice, because we got this 2 days ago and played it in one day. I mean, like, it was the only, granted, it's been snowing cold, but it is good. If you've read Red Sun at all, there's elements of that. Apparently, there is a comic book version of this story, but I mean, it is excellent. The cinematics are heavy. I mean, it is a film in and of itself. And I used to own the original or the first Injustice, and it was fun. And I remember the solo version being cool, but I didn't maybe finish it. And this was just, I don't know what qualifies as a spoiler, because it's just unlike any DC scenario that I have learned about before. It's like all the tables have turned. Everything is
Dawn of X or the whole House of X thing?
Well, no, right now I'm talking about Injustice.
Oh,
Injustice 2. I mean, the plot of it is just completely I did not see it coming. But because I read Red Sun, that was the only hint of it. So maybe I'll just say that.
Cool. Yeah, we'll talk actually weirdly some more Marvel later in terms of that stuff. And Injustice 2, in terms of like a competitive fighter,
it's
really easy to zone in that game, which can make it a very frustrating experience for people. Like Deadpool, is it Deadpool? The guy with the guns, he is a real fucker. I was playing as him when I was playing it. I'm really excited for Guilty Gear Strive to come out. And that is very exciting. Oh my God, please don't start calling me daddy. But I will say, what the fuck else?
I also got Arkham's Origins. It was just amazing. I got like 5 games for $30. And this makes me so happy as someone who's tight to the coin.
So please.
I actually got new games, and they're ones I'm really excited about. They weren't just like whoopsie daisy games. Oh, and then also Epic, which I think that sale goes on until the 25th, but Rage 2 is free.
Cool.
So that's a game that came out February of this year, and so far it's pretty fun.
I got a Jurassic Park game for the Oculus. I haven't played it yet, though, but I'm excited about that.
Wait, a game or an experience?
It's a game. You have to hide from the dinosaurs, and it's like a sneaky game. It's like a suspenseful, scary, sneaky game, and I have to play it. I keep forgetting I have it. And now I have the space to really enjoy VR, too. Not just this room, but actually the living room is very big for it.
Have you done the Star Wars games yet?
Yes. I really enjoyed Tales from the Edge of the Galaxy, and I really liked that Vader game. I played a little bit of the Star Wars shooter or Starfighter as well, game as well that came out.
What's your favorite thing you've done on VR so far?
Favorite thing I've done in VR so far might be, I really love Moss. Honestly, might be The Room, actually. The Room VR, it is an escape room VR game that does a really killer job of giving you, but by far Half-Life Alyx, 13-hour game. I forget. Like, the whole point of me getting the VR headset was to play Half-Life Alyx. And it was absolutely incredible. But I think
Punk Jess. Isn't it The Room like the movie?
I wish it was like the movie, The Room. No, I'm talking about... So, there was a mobile app game called The Room. And it was like a puzzle box game that you could play on your phone that's awesome. There's like a couple of those games. And then they made a VR experience, and then I realized, maybe the best way to do VR is escape rooms, and I wish they would make more escape room games. There's a different game called, I believe, I Expect You to Die, which I enjoyed, but I haven't beaten it yet, mainly because it doesn't checkpoint you, so if you do die, you have to start all the way at the beginning and then, like, redo a bunch of shit. Love Beat Saber. Beat Saber, I always
love,
like,
Beat Saber.
If I throw on VR, like, I'll play a couple Beat Saber levels usually just to warm up and then move on to something else.
I'm quite decent at Beat Saber, and it took a minute, but I like to play on hard. Do you play on hard?
Yeah, I've started to now. I'm starting to play on hard.
I'm just saying, throw yourself in, because I was really tentative for a long time, but
no
hard
fails
is,
or fails? With fails?
With fails.
Okay.
It's so much more fun. I mean, it is just, it's intense, and like, you really gotta go for it. The one that gets, Crab Rave is the one that we kind of joke about. And
nice.
Because it's almost impossible. And then the other one I really love is... Oh,
well, I like the BTS music pack for sure. That's a good one if you want to get some DLC. If you want a little,
we haven't done any of that. I would like to, though. I'm kind of sick of the tunes.
They need to get better stuff, though. There's like, it's like Linkin Park. Like, they couldn't have chosen a worse set of, just for me personally. Music packs. Like, and then it was the only one I was like, Green Day. And it was literally like Green Day, as soon as I stopped giving a fuck about Green Day, like all of those songs, like The American Idiot and on. And I was like, I was like, dude, nothing from Dookie. Like, seriously, like, there's so many fun.
It might have been on Jackanese, or maybe it was a Cocktails I was watching, but you shared footage of this girl who's incredibly good at Beat Saber, where they designed the things for her.
Yeah.
I totally watched that, and I'm just...
Yeah, unbelievable, right?
That was blown away. Cool, I can't even handle it.
That showcase. Next up, too, just quickly, I want to mention it, put it out in the ether so that somehow one just shows up at my door, or somebody just texts me and tells me they exist somewhere in LA or online. I still haven't gotten a... Can't find a fucking PS4 or 5. I'm losing my mind over here. I mean, I haven't been looking. I refuse to become one of these people who are waking up early and going to a card. I just can't believe they're not readily available by this point. It is February. It's the end of February. I've never seen anything like this. I feel like even with the Wii, like after a couple of months, you could just get them. And I refuse to pay extra, and I refuse to, you know, become this crazy person hunting it down and like waiting for the drops. I know there's like Twitter accounts I can follow. I think I'm more just like, I'm because at this point I want to just get to the point where I walk in the store and get the damn thing. And I'm just kind of blown away that I guess it's pandemic. I don't know what's going on. And these scalpers need to go straight to hell, especially during this pandemic. Where people are already, if you're going to jack people up, they're already exhausted. Yo, what's up, Flume? How you doing? Let's not tally the things that have been bought. You won't break it.
That's from me talking to Reagan because they say my kid is stingy and won't let me use his VR headset. He's afraid I'll break it. To be fair, he did buy it himself. I mean, totally cool that he bought it himself. However, like I said, let's not tally who's bought what here. You totally get to play.
Thank you for the bits, Apple Cart. I can't obsessively check that shit every day and fuck scalpers. I think it's more just like, now I'm mad. I'm so mad. I'm going to wait till I can just walk into a store. But if some shadow figure wants to just like give me a happy for the month of March, you know, let me know where one is or whatever. Fucking A.
I'm going to push the issue. He broke my body coming out. There you go. Let's adjust the perspective here.
Use Zoolert? What is Zool? I don't want to follow something called Zoolert. What's next, fucking?
Hi, Kyle.
What's next, fucking zebra notifications? What do we live? What hell do we live in? That we can't, that it's like this. What kind of dystopian hellscape do I live in that I can't get a PS5 and fucking 500,000
lives?
It
sounds like exactly what you'd like. It notifies you when it's in stock at online retailers.
Infuriating. It absolutely infuriating. When my day of a Sega Genesis came out, you got it. And you had the money, you got it. And then you made fun of the other kids who didn't have the money. That's how it worked. But now I have the money, I still can't get it. Where's the justice? Man, baby Spork, thank you so much. Oh, Holden, you're becoming a Sasquatch. Carly, your lipstick is lethal.
Boom.
There you go.
You're dead.
Got to try Dibbler and also Hoblo. I tried Hoblo. The app where it shows you how what the color your consistency of your piss is to find in how much alcohol versus water you've been drinking. I have Hoblo. Like,
that's
why is there no
real,
way to buy
it?
One instead of ahead of time app? Like they do with pre-order from a regular business? I don't know, Timmy Nuggy Nugs. It's these fucking scalpers that take them all, and I don't understand. Okay, here's the thing. Wilco came to New York City, right? You know this is going to be a good story because it started with that. It started with me saying the word Wilco. Wilco came to New York City. They did three nights at Hammerstein Ballroom. Scalpers bought up all the tickets and charged an arm and a leg for them. Because of that, Wilco then turned around, added a new show and a new night at a different venue. My buddy,
cool.
In order to get tickets, which my buddy did, stood in line for 3 hours with an ID. You could only get in with an ID. You could only get two tickets at a time. And they blew the doors off the place. Man. Sony, do the same thing. You know what I mean? As a band that people specifically who look like
please,
me like, Wilco.
Please. It's just me. You need to come in and like wear a scarf over your head.
Right.
All I want is PlayStation. Please, I'll sleep outside.
I just think that it's in that's Waco, Government Junior. For the love of Jesus in heaven.
Fun Waco jokes.
So, anyways, it was a fun Waco joke. So that's my piece. Let's talk about WandaVision. I do love it. We are so this week, Wizard and the Bruiser, we're doing our episode on the history of Scarlet Witch and Vision, culminating in WandaVision. It's a very interesting backstory in the sense that they're uninteresting in a lot of ways. In the sense they're kind of were arbitrarily thrown together just to have a marriage in the Avengers. They needed some romance to play with back in the 70s. But they kind of took this thing that, I will say though, led to, you know, this character and this marriage did lead to some interesting stuff, notably House of M, which I did read. If you have a Comixology Unlimited subscription, you can read all of House of M. Which is great. So I actually did that yesterday, which was also just very pleasant. You were talking about playing through Injustice 2 in a day. Like, it was so nice to just sit with like a full comic book arc on my on my balcony.
It's such a good day when you can read an entire book.
Right? And you just sit there and you know, I was blasting those. I mean, I don't even want to talk about it. We'll talk about it a different time. With the legal marijuana scenario and just sitting out there with coffee, with cold beer, reading through a story, absolutely beautiful. And it's a great story, and it very much connects to WandaVision. First of all, Carly, have you seen any of WandaVision? Also, I will try my best not to spoil shit for anybody who is watching or about to watch, because it's very spoilery.
I have seen all of it.
Okay. I have also seen all of it.
And so. I've seen most of them a couple times because we usually try and watch it before sleeping, we both fall asleep. Not only because it's excellent, but we just started way too late.
We will have a spoiler section of one of in our episode that will probably be near the end and will be announced so that you can enjoy the history and everything up until that point and then turn it off if you don't want the spoilers, because it's very spoilery, but you have to talk about it. And a lot of the history gets spoilery, especially because we look at those things that really inspired it. It's very obvious that House of M is an inspiration. House of M is a little different. It is, but it's essentially Scarlet Witch, aka Wanda. She ends up sort of losing her mind. A lot of it is the desperation of her kids being taken from her because her in the story she does through magic create two twin boys. And then you realize that they are actually like from Mephisto. They're like, it's kind of hard to explain. I'd have to like have my notes up.
Is this getting spoilery? Because
I don't think it should spoil the TV show, but it might. I don't know. Okay. But the kids are from Mephisto, whatever, right? And then and then he like absorbs them back into his body, and that's for her.
I think you should stop.
I don't think this is going to be the show, but anyways. Through dealing with that trauma, House of M, Carly, it's fine. House of M, through dealing with that trauma, she ends up kind of getting taken advantage of, and she ends up taking all of the kind of everybody's reality and making it as if Magneto won. That's why it's called House of M, like House of Magnus.
Gotcha.
And it's as if Magneto won, and we sort of live in a mutant dominant world where the mutants run everything. As opposed to a coexistent world where the mutants and the humans coexist in an Xavier, right?
And that's a little more with Dawn of X. There's, you know, that's all about there being a separate mutant island. And this is not spoilery at all. But what happens when the mutants have a place to call home? I'll just leave it at that.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So anyways, House of M, definitely read it. It's really fascinating. Even more so, they took, I think, from a different comic run that I just started called The Vision, which is dope as fuck. It came out in 2016.
Cool.
And it is so cool and weird. It definitely feels more like WandaVision was very inspired by this because it's very much Vision. After certain events, Scarlet's out of the picture. Vision creates his own. You know how Vision is a, what is he, a symbiote or whatever it's called?
Yeah. Well, he's Jarvis.
Like a robot. He's sort of like a living robot. He ends up making a wife and two kids. And they try to live this very cookie cutter life in this very suburban neighborhood, right? Does this sound familiar?
Oh, interesting.
And it's, so it's almost reverse WandaVision. It's like Vision's engineering the thing. You know what I mean? And he's like, and he's sort of kind of trying to force a quote unquote normal life on everybody. And things go very awry. It's like really dark from the get go. It's really sad and dark and interesting.
Yeah.
And that's kind of the interesting thing about these characters. No more. I don't think any of that spoils anything, to be honest with you. Cause like,
I mean, again, it's amazing. You know,
but
it's an amazing show to watch. Nothing we could say ruins anything.
They're doing a really cool thing with this show because I think that the characters are very fascinating because, like, they're in a sense throwaway characters a little bit. or at least not like super memorable characters. They also have very tragic backstories, like Ultron created Vision, right? We know, and by the way, Age of Ultron, all right? Sorry, it's been done, okay?
That's okay. That's a
Ultron
lot,
creates Vision, right? He sort of comes from evil. And also Wanda, it was retconned, but Wanda was Magneto, is Magneto's daughter, right? And so both of them should on paper be evil, but they end up deep down being good. And I think that that is really fascinating. Sweet Baby Corn, I will tell you why you need to invest in a Disney Plus account. You need to invest in a Disney Plus account because every motherfucking episode of The Muppet Show is on that bitch now.
I just saw that.
It's awesome. Dude, talk about a great way to end the night. And I will say so for Valentine's Day, I got Lexi a nice, lovely TV for the bedroom. So now we can kick it in bed and watch stuff. And it is such a great way to end the evening is with a Muppet Show episode.
I love
but
Muppet
she's
Show.
Such a good mood. It's just so nice and easy and chill and fun. So very good.
Tight of fate. I don't know what you're talking about.
I know.
But
I'm
the
sure
Muppet Show
has
makes
a,
me really happy.
I'm sure a guest has a dark past.
Oh, no, I'm sure.
Yeah, we'll be streaming till for another 2 hours and change. Absolutely. So go get that shit.
So we're coming up on the end of the first hour. I've got one more thing to share, but it's really just to leave on in the background while we chat.
Oh, let me put up the
video. If you want.
So this is just you dying to dance again?
It's just dancing, yeah. Because here's the thing. Okay, so I'm reading like this cool sci-fi book. It's called Pushing Ice. It's by Alistair Reynolds.
Crowley.
Not Crowley.
Interesting.
I think it's Reynolds. I have to check because I actually care that you all know this. It has to be right. Yeah, Alistair Reynolds. And I'm really enjoying that. But I didn't really want to get into the... Can they hear the music, even though I can't?
I did not share the music, but I'm keeping it on quite low just because I want us to be able to archive this episode and keep it on Twitch.
Okay.
Do you need them to hear the song? I'm so excited
dancing.
By the Pointer Sisters.
It doesn't make a ton of sense without the music, but that's cool. We can just watch a bunch of dancey clips. So here's the thing. Mr. Crowley, no. We can hear it a bit. Okay, that's all it takes. So the book I'm reading is super fun and all, but then this morning, for whatever reason, we were looking at Fred Astaire clips because, you know, trying to show this four-year-old child, like, some stuff that's, like, tap dancing, you know. I was showing him capoeira the other day. Like, there's this stuff that he's never been exposed to. And so we like to look up different dancing videos to show him people dancing. And this particular video, because it is pretty, like, across the board, it is a lot of different dancey clips. It made me really happy. And so that's why I wanted to
Amir
share it.
And Juliet, we just did our pop history on that, which was a really fun episode.
Yeah.
Coming out soon.
And yes, for those of you who know me, I love to dance. I sincerely miss dancing. However, watching this video just kind of made me feel good. Like, we will all dance together again. And people have been dancing in their own way, you know, for quite some time. Although, it does make me wish that more dudes would dance in that partner dancing. I think partner dancing is so cool. And any time in my life where I've been like, I'm gonna take a class in it, I could never really find even like buddies who would give it a go.
I will say I definitely
guys having the best time.
First of all, Footloose, very fun movie to go back and watch. Second of all, because we did Baz Luhrmann's Romeo and Juliet, I actually do want to watch Strictly Ballroom soon.
Oh, it's excellent.
Fantastic,
it's so
right?
Good.
And also, Mighty Spearman, the Dune cast, we recorded the first episode last week.
Oh, yeah.
Week.
Cool.
We are recording the next 2 episodes this week, and I believe we're releasing at some point in March. I think I actually should know the date, but I don't. So it's happening. It should be happening within the next 4 weeks, I bet. I'm going to go ahead and say.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm excited for that.
I'm just trying to, now I'm trying to read book five of Dune, and now we've hit sort of the less,
we all need to dance.
Well, I don't even know, because maybe I'll enjoy, I don't know, people don't talk about five and six as highly as they talk about the first four, so I'm already like, oh boy. And, you know, wouldn't you know it, they're just as long as all the other ones. You would think, you would hope they were shorter. So I'm reading the fifth book right now, and I'm just staring down the barrel of a sixth book, potentially a seventh book, if I want to read the one his son wrote to kind of finish the whole thing. Well, we break it all down for you, Jackal. I mean, we kind of break it all down, and you know, so I think you can appreciate it as both a book club that you're, because you're keeping up with the books, or you are, or I think you can enjoy. I think you'll be able to enjoy it, Matt. Just without.
Not to throw you off of the Dune, but we just missed, and I'm sure she'll come back. But can we all acknowledge how much we love Anne Margaret?
Okay. Because,
I mean, do you not love Anne Margaret? She is so like Bye Bye Birdie, right? Or Tommy, uh-huh. Right? She is this amazing fortress of just both cute and utterly seductive and smart, and just like, she's such a badass. And watching this little clip made me remember how much I love Anne Margaret.
And yes, Ruby Rod, absolutely. I guess I'm guessing they did Fifth Element. I was looking at chat. I'm 150 pages into book one. Now I'm supposed to read House of X, Dune, and still participate in society. Look, it's not going to happen. So you got to give up one, and I'm going to go with society. Yeah. Since, anyways,
one
you can't
at
really
time.
Enjoy it much at all these days, regardless. All right, here we go.
Awesome.
Bringing
dancing
in
for you.
Our first guest, and only guest. We're bringing in the only guest. Also, we will be doing the books in order. The first four episodes will just be on the first book, and then we'll continue to explore after that, obviously book by book. But also, once you get past the first book, which is that traditional hero's journey, you end up actually moving into this other territory that is like this philosophical kind of stuff that is kind of goes outside, I feel like, of just explaining plot points. So I'm excited to get into that territory, because that's kind of where it really opens up.
Here. House of X isn't too bad. Dawn of X.
Break on through by the doors. I think I'm just going to do that. Yeah, very good. It's a very good book series.
It's so good.
That's the only thing you lose. I have a tablet now, but the one thing I lose with that is I don't get those cool, you know, the cool additions to put on my bookshelf and this, that, and the other. As you can see, all my Berserks are behind me. And I've got everything on that row right there. It's kind of hard to see. But I think everything, that's Wiffle Washer. I have to take that off. Most everything on this row right there is stuff I've covered on Wizard and the Bruiser.
That's cool.
Or I believe Mariah Carey's book is in there too. So, or Pop History.
Or, there you go.
Yeah. Pretty awesome.
Yeah. It's House of X is a great place to start. And then you're going to be hungry for more. So get ready to read Dawn of X. At first I read the first seven, and then we just picked up, I believe it goes up to book 11 right now. I'm also waiting patiently for Saga. I would really like another Saga book to come out.
Nice. By the way, while we wait for Marie, I'm just going to do Break On Through by the Doors.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Day destroys the night. The night divides the day. Tried to run, tried to hide. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side, yeah. I tried to go up in pitch, it didn't work. We chased our pleasures here, dug our treasures there. But can you still recall the time we cried? Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side, yeah. I'm drunk on stage, but I'm high on life. It's me, Jim Morrison. I'll fuck it up, all right? You know what I mean? I'll fuck your bitch. You understand? It's me, drunk Jim Morrison. I'm here to get arrested for showing my dick to you people. You know what I mean? These guys. Everybody loves my baby. Everybody loves my baby. She gets. I'm a poet. She gets. E. G. she gets. Oh. Oh, let me bring Marie in. Oh, yeah. Arms to chain us, eyes to lie. Bring on through to the other side. Bring on through to the other side. Bring on through. Oh, oh yeah. Welcome, Marie. Just doing a little karaoke. You know how it goes.
Love it.
Mentally sings week to week, day to day, hour to hour, day to straight. Not gay, deep and wide. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through. Break on through. Break on through. Break on through. Yeah, 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 yeah. You fucks, you're welcome.
Excellent.
Thank you. Hello.
Thank you, EI Limited. Is that what I say? EILTD? So it's coming back soon. I'm very excited about that.
What is? Oh.
Saga.
The Saga's coming back soon? Did they make an announcement?
Major cliffhanger. And Marie is here. I'm so, so sorry.
Welcome,
well, I want to know what the cliffhanger is. What's going on?
I feel like Saga is a comic book series that if it was made into a TV show, it would probably be like your favorite TV show, Marie. Like, no joke.
Oh, yeah, probably. Definitely. Is it like Outlander?
It sort of has like, it's got like the shit you liked about Game of Thrones mixed with the shit you like about Mandalorian. Like, I just
sci-fi,
know, I
aliens.
Just, it kind of has all of it that you like in a show, in a comic. I had no idea. Oh, speaking of Screen Rant, Wasn't the Bruiser
so
made it on a Screen Rant list for best video game podcast? How fun
is
that? So when was this? January 28th? Confirmed he and Fiona Staples were hard at work in the return of the series. So the cool thing about this series, definitely check this out, Marie. Do you read comics at all?
No, I can't read pictures.
Lexi's kind of like, I feel like Lexi's finally gotten better at it. But I was like, she was like, I don't know how to like read the panel. Like, I never know what order it's in. I was like, oh, I guess that's just something. It's the same thing like when I put a controller in her hand for a video game. She's just like, I don't know what the fuck to use this. You're like, oh, right. I've been doing this since I was in fourth grade. But check out Saga. It is, and write it down twice, please, because it would make me mad
Saga.
At you if you only wrote it down.
Saga.
Saga.
Okay.
The simplest word you could possibly imagine.
I need activities.
you will
Wait,
love it.
Look at my apartment. You guys.
I was
going
to say it looks
am.
Great.
I'm going to just show you real quick. And then, Holden, I want a tour. I don't know if you do a tour on this.
I wish
I'm so
I could.
Curious.
I'd have to sign on my laptop. But
right. But this is, so I've been slowly decorating. Guys, I just moved to Nashville. So this is, I've been collecting stuff from Facebook Marketplace.
Hell yeah.
Look, it's like a hotel.
That's awesome.
But it's my fucked in.
Nice.
But you can't.
Have you fucked any dicks in there yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
There's a pandemic.
So you haven't sucked any penises or done any of that?
Oh, wait, maybe.
Did you get a hand, actually. Did you get a
actually,
man
we got tested. We got tested. I'm seeing this very nice gentleman.
Ooh.
He's
right?
Yeah, I think you guys would really like him. He actually knows you. Is familiar with the group, but he's an actor, like a profesh actor. He's actually booked a show. He's going 2 weeks to film this big thing.
Are you sure he's
Can't
not
say.
Lying and that he's just some kind of a drifter
I did think
with
he
a
was,
gambling
yeah,
problem?
I was talking to a fraudster fan and Cena was like, you cannot break up with him. If you break up with him, we'll lose a listener. You have to make babies so that there's more listeners. I was like, I can't do that.
Unbelievable.
He'd go bye-bye. Anyway.
So, but you're not pregnant.
No.
Okay, great.
I think I'm barren. But you are. Wait, Holden. I'm so excited.
It's so exciting. Did you see the picture? Do you have Twitch up? Oh, you saw the baby picture earlier?
Yeah. Oh, no, wait. No way. What?
Yeah. I post. Or,
like
I put it. When we did our first hour, we do week in review. But anyways, it's there. I could kind of show it to you, I guess. Well, no. If I share screen, it'll mess up my setup.
Okay. Well, I'll check back then.
You're great.
But it's like the picture in her belly.
Yeah, she got it today.
Whoa.
And it looks great. She's got a head. I gotta stop saying it. She has a head and a
oh
neck and a little
God.
Body now, and she's moving around. She's really shaking and moving every time we get a
How far along are you guys?
14 weeks. We'll be 15 on Thursday.
Oh my gosh.
I know. So we're now in the second trimester, which is great. Because apparently the second trimester is the best trimester. Like it's sort of like because the first one you're like nauseous. You're like every day around 5 p.m. she would get super nauseous. I mean, which super sucks. Like because we could be out eating burgers, or we could be having hot dogs, or we could be out eating breakfast for dinner, whatever, you know what I mean, Mexican, or whatever. Usually it would be eating
like,
what we're doing.
Blah.
Or like she could be watching me do cocaine in like a nightclub or whatever, right? And then she just gets nauseous, and she's also like, why are you doing cocaine in a nightclub at 5 p.m.? What is the problem there?
Holden, quit licking the stripper pole. It's a pandemic, and I'm pregnant, and I'm going to puke.
I was like, I want COVID AIDS.
Oh my God. And this is the baby's room, right?
This will be the baby's room. 100%. I lose this room. I was so happy to finally get an office, and I lose this room immediately to a baby.
It. Oh my God. It's huge.
Just this room. I know, right? And that's like the smallest room in the apartment. We've got this. The bedroom's huge. We got two bathrooms, a huge living room and kitchen, and a dining room space, and a big ass balcony.
Oh, their place is awesome. It's great. So nice.
Oh, my God.
Once we get a little more together, I will actually sign on like, my phone and do, like, it's still coming. It's still a little scrappy right now.
Wow, that's so exciting. You must feel like a brand new person.
Yes, I do. I feel like a new person. It hasn't really hit me. She's a man baby. It hasn't really hit me because you know how it is, Marie. I mean, you just dealt with this, and Carly, too. You just go, and that's kind of the beauty of moving is, like, there's so much to do that you can't even think about, like, the actual transition until like, a week after because you're literally – you can't even go, like, holy shit, I live in L.A. now because you just – every day there's just so much shit to take care of, and now I feel like we're finally settling, and it's like, oh, wait. Where do we live? But I do. I love the neighborhood. Beautiful neighborhood. Mm-hmm. I love our street. Like, it's just.
Are you near everybody?
Yeah. We're like a 5 to 10 minute drive from everybody. I can't like walk to anybody's place, but that's fine. I don't care.
Right.
You know, everybody
nobody
drives
walks
anyways.
And, yeah.
Who
nobody
walks?
It's LA. I tried walking in LA.
Fridge.
It's LA. Yeah. Who walks? This is a funny story. Lexi was out walking, speaking of walking, and she saw two expecting mothers on a walk together. Uh-huh. She was like, oh, I wonder if we could be friends. I should listen to what they're talking to. And one of them to the other was like, I'm thinking about getting my eyes done. And then Lexi was just like, I'm... I was like, never mind. I live in LA. It's like, yeah, we live in LA. What I do love is... We've got it all right close to us. We got juice bar, fucking salad
place.
If we turn vegan,
we're not friends.
No, not friends. There's also Five Guys, but
oh, good, thank God.
but it is not. I was actually lamenting about this in a story. I was like, there's not that good, just like salad place for when I do want to eat like a healthy person. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like all my go-tos in Astoria are horrible for me.
Burgers.
And like if I want to eat well, I kind of have to get my own stuff. You know,
I love salads in Astoria. They put lamb on top of that, some pita bread, and some.
You want extra grease? You want extra grease? I'm like, I don't want any grease.
I got a pita. I thought I was so healthy, and there was just like layers of French fries.
Oh yeah,
we got Italian food yesterday, which we haven't really done here, and got a Caesar salad to be like, you know, a little salad on the side. It was just iceberg lettuce with carrots. Covered in Caesar salad, like packet dressing, like to the max.
That's terrible.
I was like,
love
well,
it. A Midwestern salad.
No, I should.
By the way, carrots in a Caesar salad?
Yeah, that's weird.
Ew.
Caesar just means Caesar dressing as opposed to ranch.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah.
Look at us, though. We all have left New York City.
We're gone.
Jesus.
We did it.
We did it.
Remember, I probably brought this up having you on as a guest before, and I think Carly was even there. It was a rehearsal for a John Teutcherman, and you were there, Marie, and you told everybody in the room, you held up this on your phone, this article about this new virus coming, and you were like, guys, this is going to be big. And we were like, okay. But even you didn't have any concept of what that meant. And we were all like, okay. But it was really Marie was the first person to really say to me in a room full of people who all were used to doing this monthly streaming thing together, by the way, with Twitchermen, just like, this is going to be like actually a life-changing scenario. And we're all like, oh, okay, maybe. Marie's a real coward about her news
story.
Initially,
I thought 2 months max. And now that I'm almost a year in Kansas, I'm just like, who knew?
Yeah.
Like,
I just remember going to my hotel job, because it was like, they fired everybody a week later. But at my hotel job, I was like, this is it. Goodbye, guys. And nobody knew about the pandemic or like anything about China, anything, like these fucking idiots. And then I said goodbye, and then I never saw them again.
Yeah.
That's right. It was me. It's my fault.
There's a lot of people I say goodbye to, I can't believe I will never see them again.
I know.
You know what I mean?
There's a lot of those people.
Is what it is.
We will meet again, you guys.
Don't know where.
Marie Poppins. Marie Poppins will come take care of your baby.
But exactly.
No matter where
Marie,
you gotta come take care
of our baby.
I mean, like, get breastfeeded.
Please. I think it'll take to your nipple. Thank you, Koala, for gifting Mystery a sub. Also, I did mention Guilty Gear Strive, and it is very exciting, but I've only watched other people play it. I want to wait till it comes out. But thank you so much. Also, here are the incentives. $5 will do an animal impression of your choice. $10 to choose one of us to perform a karaoke song of your choice. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I usually just give everything to Carly. So whatever you donate, it goes to a good cause. Carly lives in a barn, okay?
Lives in a barn.
This is the Free Carly Movement, okay?
But hold on. Now you have a child on the way. I'm hoping that you can raise more money because you have a child on the way.
I would donate. I'm kind of groovy about it. I think a child won't cost that much extra. No, apparently it is.
Old Mizzen for a treat.
Apparently, baseline is 13 G a year, an extra 13 G a year, just baseline. How much you'll figure it out. How much it costs.
That's actually nothing compared to.
But then, if you
want to
throw your baby
towards
like a fun cotillion, which I plan to do pretty early on, like that's mad, another 13 grand. And I want to have baby cotillions. I want to have like essentially what you see in shows like Bling Empire or in shows, you know, like the real what about the Real House Husbands of Los Angeles? Okay. I'm surprised they haven't tried that actually yet. Have they not done a Real House Husbands yet?
Oh, I'm sure it's on the way.
I don't know, but Reformed Horrors has a house husband song. It'd be perfect theme song.
Love it. Wait, is this new or this was on one of your older albums?
It hasn't been recorded yet. But it really makes the audience uncomfortable.
Shemaine, baby, thank you for the dollar. Kyle Kopp, who's no longer M. DeLeo Spaceman. He's now Kyle Kopp. And with the $1, he says, for a diaper. So that's nice.
Oh, baby, one diaper. I love that.
See, your fans are so nice.
For a single diaper. But
a diaper is probably like $3.
Yeah,
I guess
a diaper might be actually more expensive than that, Kyle. So I guess I'll wipe my fucking ass with that dollar, but we'll see what happens. I'll just roll up a bunch of legal weed into the dollar and then
throw
it at someone.
Have you been going to dispensaries?
Of course. I have one two blocks from my apartment. We got one. So I went.
I've never been to one.
Oh, really? Oh, you'll love it. I mean, it's just completely normal in adults. It's completely normal.
It's not weird at all.
It's completely
normal.
You just
go in.
It's kind of funny how quickly you adjust to just like, this is no longer a stigmatized thing. No one cares. Another good thing about any town that has legal marijuana is you, in a very positive way, not in a negative way at all when I say this, everybody's just a little high. Everybody's just a little less aggro, a little less intense. You can tell. I noticed it in Denver when I went to Denver. I notice it here. There's just when legal
like
hits.
Cooler.
Because especially no one's like just there's no people aren't like laying out in the streets. You know what I mean? Because first of all, it's like it's just weed. It's not, you know, fucking space fake weed or whatever or heroin. Second of all, everybody gets adult about it really quick, and so everybody kind of microdoses and stuff. You know what I mean? Speaking of which, actually, this was the time I was going to enjoy my first edible for the night, so I'm going to go grab that. Marie, Nashville, when are you guys getting it?
Not in Tennessee. They hate women and marijuana.
No,
it's really
not kind. See, I'm in Kansas.
Wait, I should eat a gummy, too. I did bring – I was like a –
This is a
good
one.
Are the cops watching?
Fruit.
I was like a mule.
This is a good sativa 10 milligram orange flavor. It's very yummy.
Mm. Let me get my.
The only thing I hate is the child proofing on the packages.
You're going to appreciate that in a little bit.
Very soon.
Yeah.
These are great. Really simple.
It's interesting where I am in Kansas because we're very close to Missouri. And apparently there are places you can drive just over the state line.
But the problem with Kansas is they still have the town dog law in Kansas, where if you get caught smoking marijuana in Kansas, they dress you like the town dog and you have to act like the town dog for a week. And if you don't,
I wish it was
that. Every
time
you say human words during that week, you get hard-arded. Yeah. Yes.
Whoa.
You get sexually assaulted by the sheriff of Kansas.
No, I one thing I do appreciate about Kansas is there are no neighbors really. The closest neighbor is like a 5 minute, 7 minute walk away. I love
this. Blows my mind. Like, literally,
know, right?
All of a sudden, Carly's like, I live on a farm in a barn with That's no great. Neighbors.
Are you doing,
what were you gonna say?
Well, I was gonna ask Marie, are you doing a are you solo one bedroom situation in Nashville?
That's oh, yeah, awesome.
Sweet.
Yeah. I mean, check this shit out.
It's very
it's
cute.
Great.
You're my doing a really in. Nice job.
Awesome.
That's the cat. There's Madonna's awesome. Titties. See, when people make love, they can look at Madonna if they don't want to look at me.
That's very kind of you.
I know. And then the shower, I have to squeegee it every time I get in, but it's very nice. And my rent is $945.
Wow.
Which is insane for a one bedroom
that's
in Nashville,
that's
really.
Awesome. Yeah, yeah, for sure.
So that's anyway, awesome. I feel, and my neighborhood is awesome. Like, there's sidewalks, there's all these cute, these really cool bars and restaurants. Cause I was out in the burbs there for 3 months.
Yeah.
And I was it was miserable.
It's too quiet.
Miserable.
Well, here's my
and
question.
And Trump supporters on both sides, which is, that's fine.
No,
wherever you
no,
are
not.
Political. Yep. No, it's not.
It's not that.
Yeah, it was rough. It was,
well, you
I
know,
got
it's,
down
it's
and I just
you,
was like, oh.
This is the difference. This is the difference. It's that you knew. How did you know, Marie? Were there giant fucking obnoxious flags out front of their apartment?
Yeah, both signs, American flags and Trump's.
Yeah,
Trump's
that's
sign.
Why.
Yeah.
It's the fact that you knew immediately because of the fucking grandstanding and obnoxiousness. By the way, are those flags still up?
No, they took them down, yes.
That's fun. Isn't
See,
that nice?
My folks in Texas have been sharing with me when their neighbors have started to take the signs down.
That's awesome.
I think that is very interesting.
I love that.
Like, what is... That. At what point is it appropriate?
Oh, God. Are you just finding out, Moonbaster, that Daft Punk broke up? Yeah, dude.
What? They broke up?
Yeah, they broke up today.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So I guess you won't be getting lucky, Marie. So there you go.
Was everything riding on Daft Punk?
Yes.
Oh, no.
I also
was late to the Kim Kanye party, too.
Yeah, they're getting divorced.
Wow, I didn't see that coming.
But also, what was I going to say? I was also going to say to Marie, ask you, so you were in an apartment in a big city. You moved to Nashville. Mm-hmm. Now you're way happier in an apartment, mm-hmm. but still in a big mm-hmm. city. So what is the big difference between your situation in Nashville compared to your situation in Brooklyn?
Well,
did you just make a job? Did you just... You just waste your time.
With my pants. No. Well, I mean, the thing is about New York that I do miss is like that competitive, like hustler, like, creative energy and flow that city has. Like, it's just amazing. And then here, like everyone, I mean, again, it's a pandemic, so I'm not out and about really, but it's the music scene really drives Nashville, which I'm not too interested in right now. I'm really interested in the comedy scene here. There's actually, they're building all these other comedy clubs and stuff on this side of town.
Cool.
Because Zany's is here.
Yeah.
But we're blacklisted from Zany's. I think I told you this story.
Why are y'all blacklisted from Zany's?
No, it's like a political thing. But we worked with the owner of the club as a manager. And then we had a big falling out. They told us that we were too difficult, which I took and put as the name of our podcast, Difficult Women.
Perfect.
These men told us we were too difficult, and we were like, well, your club sucks.
Well,
so
were
you
being difficult?
We were not being difficult. They were just, they weren't getting it. They, because Reformed Whores, they just like were trying to put us out on the road with Ralphie May and stuff. And, and just like other comics that like really were pretty dirty and like hating on women so much. And we just didn't work. Our stuff does not work with like dirty jokes, like super dirty jokes, you know? It kind of works against us because then we go out into the audience and they like women suck. And then we're like trying to empower every woman. And, you know, so our agents and managers just didn't get it. But one of the managers is club owner of Zany's and now we can't perform there.
That's
so that's great.
I the only problem with like a Zany's or whatever is I know my buddy's dealing with this in Charlotte when he opened up like a little improv room is that like there's always that one club that sort of does everything they can to be the monopoly over the town of like so they'll like blacklist comics who perform at other clubs in the town and do all these little things that fuck you over as a person trying to be outside of that one central club. So
well, I'm already blacklisted, so it works great.
Reagan Piper Rose says, how dare you speak your mind and stand up for yourselves, you difficult women, you.
That's right, I love it.
Nothing is more empowering to me than girls poop too. Hell yeah, Ryan Osmosis.
There were certainly plenty of music clubs, even in New York, all right, that were like, you've got a gig here. You can't perform anywhere for the month prior or the month after.
Well, UCB did that.
Oh, yeah.
Or you, well, no. Mercury Lounge is what you're thinking of.
Mercury Lounge.
But UCB, when we got a resident, we didn't get a residency there. They offered us one, but then they told us we couldn't perform anywhere else or have a show anywhere else if we were going to have a residency with them. And we were just like, we perform like 3 nights a week. So, no.
Yeah, we're not stopping every single. Venue that we work
Arlene's with. Grocery was like that too.
Right.
We were supposed to do a show and they're like, you can't do a show 6 weeks before or after. And we're like, we perform 3 days a week. Like,
one thing I really love, you guys know that Our Wicked Lady, which is a venue and bar in Brooklyn, that was one of the places they had the dance night. They have been really struggling because they got their liquor license somehow revoked during this time. They haven't done anything wrong. It's like some bureaucratic stuff amongst like not actually being open and like struggling to make any money. And then they got, you know, gut punched. So they're trying to stay open. And what I think is interesting about it is you see other venues actually coming to their aid. Like their competitors are coming through and saying like, this is a great place. Like a community needs lots of venues. It needs lots of different places.
Then it's a scene.
It's a scene. It should not be competitive in that way that you're, and the burden falling on the performers. That's bullshit.
Oh yeah, totally. All that shit.
New York is going to be unrecognizable. That's the sad thing that I think.
But it'll
is
be in
happen.
A way, hopefully.
It'll evolve.
Be, you know, once everything changes. The beauty about New York, though, is it's like it's such a constantly changing organism that, like, and it got so cookie cutter, too, that it's getting a little bit of its edge back, to be honest with you. And, like, all the people that do. And honestly, if we were in our 20s, we would have stuck it out probably and, like, been a part of the wave. But we're at the point where, like, it's really hard for us to be in just back against the wall. Like, I don't love New York enough for that, personally.
Yeah, that's how. You know? I had other places to be.
I was also
that's kind of how I.
I'm not one of the abandoners like the two of you female women. I had already planned to leave New York. And then, actually, my plans got pushed back. So, you're the New York abandoners. I'm not in that camp.
Abandoner,
I'm just the dude who had LA dreams.
Is very judgmental. I will come straightforward and say, how the fuck was I going to pay to stay in New York?
That's kind of my deal. My roommate moved out and I was like, I'm supposed to get another stranger to move in during a pandemic.
That's the difference, Marie. That's the answer to my question.
Out of pocket where it's like month to month and okay with it because, you know, like I had a decent life where I wasn't working retail, but I was not saving money. So the pandemic hit and I was like, oh, great. I can't teach children anymore. There goes my job.
Yep. There goes my baby.
My rent didn't go away.
She's a man baby. Dude, yo, Pig Bulls, you gifted another sub to Government Junior. Dude, thank you so much. 103 gifted subs to the channel, and I believe that is just this week. You're fucking amazing.
You sweetheart.
Also, we did get a donation from Dingle Tuck. I'm eating tacos, watching my favorite streamer.
Dingle Tuck,
so
I love that. I like that name.
That's funny.
Also, yeah, I think you said maybe Tequila, the song Tequila, fantastic.
Oh, good. But I mean, the thing is, like, I do not feel that I abandoned New York either. No, I think this is important to say out loud, and that I mean, that life is still sort of alive in my memory in a weird way.
Mm-hmm.
Where, come on, we created our entire group of friends through working together, through all of that. So it's still happening. I don't feel like I've left that behind. And I think everybody's had to change the way they communicate and all that. But I'm enjoying the change of pace, and yet I don't feel...
I love
like
it. I'm
lost
so happy.
Anything
I love
yet.
I'm all obviously too. I'm obviously joking too. I there is a funny like vibe about. There's like a funny energy about New York to the people who left during this time. You know what I mean? There's
sure.
a lot of like grandstanding, a lot of holding the hand to the flame, and you know what I mean, kind of thing.
You went to LA, which
yeah.
that has its own thing.
I didn't even know the logistics of this. Did you fly?
Sure, I can
talk
about it.
Oh, they made it.
So we flew. Yeah, we did it. So the nice thing about pandemic was there's nothing fun to do, really. There's no, you know, we were going to go to Greece and spend all this money on a, you know, on like a
right.
honeymoon kind of thing. Blah, 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 blah. And,
you got to take a baby moon.
What?
You got to take a baby moon.
Baby moon.
Oh, like a honeymoon, but for babies.
So we yeah. fly in Marie and Carly. Baby. You become the sort of mothers for a week. We'll film a sitcom intro for that.
And that's
then
very
we'll
fun.
Go somewhere fun. We'll go to some kind of a, we'll go to some orgy
house. Go to a winery.
House. We'll go to
ooh,
no,
an
we're
orgy.
A winery. We're going to go to an orgy house. We're going to go find wherever the new Charles
yes.
Manson desert
yes.
camp is.
Let's get Lexi pregnant twice.
By a different guy.
Yeah, and there'd be like two babies,
which would be fun. Yeah,
that'd be
and then
so
we'll
fun.
And then we'll try to figure out who wants to raise who. It'll be so fun.
Yeah,
but
it'd be like
anyways.
A pinata too. It'd be like, what's coming out?
But anyways,
okay, back to the
what was I gonna say? But yeah, we. So what you do is if you can afford it, because I think there's many different ways. Like, but you know, we saved up our money in order to do this. Like, that's all we did last year. So we got to do it slightly in style. I mean, you could even do it a little more stylishly than we did. But I flew out here. Actually, Cena and Cosmo are doing it more in style than we are.
Yeah,
like, but
I love their way.
Yeah, their way is even cushier because they still haven't. But I would be kind of losing my mind if they were them. They haven't found their place yet. Like,
yeah.
they came out here. They put all their shit in storage and came out here. And they have, like, 2 months to take their time and find a place, which I appreciate. But at the same time, by week
that's
two
right, yeah.
in an Airbnb, it's a nice house they're staying in. They're staying in like their friend's house. It's very nice. But still, mm-hmm. I'd be like, where am I going to live? Like, I would just want this solved as soon
yeah.
as possible. And I love the place we
barn.
Found. So I'm happy with this situation. But we flew out for a week. I flew out for a week. She was pregnant. That's why she didn't come with me. I came out here, stayed with between Henry's place and Ed's place, essentially, the whole time, and looked for a place, scrambled. I mean, there's a lot of places right now, you know, obviously,
yeah.
right? I don't know if you probably – that's probably how you found the steel in Nashville so easily, right? It's like,
well, surprisingly, everyone's moving to Nashville, so I actually knew the past tenant. So I got in because she went to Appalachian State, and – I had my professor call her and tell her that I was really nice.
That's great.
It was funny because they had they had like 20 applicants or something. So anyway, it was hard to
damn.
Get this place. But
20
yeah.
applicants.
I'm so glad though,
yeah.
Marie. I'm so
I know.
Glad.
I got lucky. It's just because it's so cheap compared yeah. to, you know.
And cute.
I love it.
It's
so
awesome.
Fun. I can't wait for y'all to visit in 2027 or something.
So yeah, I know, right? So flew out, found a place in a week, flew back, packed.
Good job.
A team of people showed up on Friday, took all of our shit out of the apartment, you know, into a giant truck and left with all of our shit. Bye. We hope to see you in 2 weeks. It actually showed up in like a week, which was kind of amazing. We
wow.
thought it was going to take 2 to 3 weeks, showed up in 1 week, maybe because of better traffic. They probably skipped some mandatory way stations, I'm going to guess, along the way in order to
right.
do that. But either way. and then with like we packed too much, by the way, but with like multiple pieces of luggage and yada, yada, yada. We stayed in a hotel in Astoria Friday night. Saturday, we flew out and stayed at an Airbnb for a week. And for 2 weeks. Okay, this was the move. We stayed in the Airbnb for 2 weeks. They came in a week, thank God, because then we got to spend the next week going here and slowly, like, setting the apartment up.
Amazing.
But then staying at the Airbnb, so we didn't have to, like, do what I've done in the past, which is, like, unpack in a day, essentially.
Yeah,
like,
I hate that
where you're,
shit.
Like, racing against the clock. Like, we have to literally set this bed up because we need a place to sleep tonight kind of shit. Like, instead, we got to just come here, do a little work, go home, you know. But it has just been exhausting. It has been a month-long ordeal, and I feel like we just finally got the place to where I don't have to wake up every day and do like eight things to get the apartment to a point. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Where I don't feel like I'm like we where I don't feel like I'm like, this table is, I guess, our coffee table right now until we get one. Like, we're a little past that phase, right? Where like nothing makes sense. There's like weird but I actually, one thing I will say is I love like putting shit together, like IKEA shit or like stuff like that. I actually, I'll get just baked out, throw on a dumb superhero movie, and just like the act of like slowly constructing something and then like at the end being like, I made a dining room table, you know what I mean? Which is one of the things I did, right?
I am the opposite of that. I put together this media thing on Saturday, put the last piece on, had done the first step wrong. So the thing didn't work. I had to take the whole thing apart. And I wasn't even drunk or stoned. I was just completely sober. And
I think you should have been stoned.
I'm going to show you what I've been making.
Oh my God, it's so annoying.
Okay, Carly's going to show us what she's making. Holden, never give up. I don't even, I mean, when did I say anything about give up? It's always funny when someone says anything, I'm like, wait, does it sound like I'm going to give up? I didn't want to give up. Who's giving up?
You did just say that you love putting IKEA furniture together. Like, you just live. You have life to still live.
And having a balcony. Oh my God!
Oh my
in
God.
Heaven.
Yeah.
From
well, I'm
who...
on the first floor.
That's
I was
nice.
On that the fifth floor.
Walk up
for 15 years. Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Mama.
So the fact that I can open my door and go outside
Dude,
is
I
just.
Lived in the, I lived on the fifth floor and I had an elevator though. I couldn't imagine having.
Every single. Emily Fleming took a nap on the third floor. Oh my God, that's amazing.
Big Bullets, thank you for the gifted sub. Emily Fleming took a nap on the third floor. Finished
she
that
couldn't
story.
Make it. She couldn't make it up
oh,
to the fifth floor. We used to get shit-faced and like she just had to sleep on the third floor because she couldn't climb.
Yeah, Carly, what was that real quick?
Oh my God.
A board game. So these are the cards. But I can make as many as I want because it's our board game. And so it has to do all with like things that are here. You know.
Wait, you made this and then you guys sit around and play it?
We haven't played it yet. There's
That's
Roddy
so
Piper.
Cute.
Look at him. He's so funny.
That is so cute.
Yes, I'm just like making little cards for the different things that we've done.
Nice.
And then eventually you'll be able to use these cards to go around the board.
Very cool. That's very cool.
Have you fucked on the board yet?
No.
But have you fucked on the board yet?
No, it's for the child.
We haven't.
Oh, it's for the child.
We haven't slapped it. I think we've only slapped it out in the bedroom since we've been here. But we did bang out in the Airbnb. That was like just a one room.
I wonder if hormones. You don't want to hurt the child. That's what you're saying.
Sounds Squeeze says, "Lol, Marie is lonely." Is there truth in that statement, Marie? I love
you
the lol.
Well, last week there was a full snowstorm and I didn't see a single person for 7 days.
Yeah. So Carly didn't have like plumbing for multiple days.
Yeah, we haven't had plumbing for about a week.
She was
we just
pissing
got it
off
back
the
today.
Porch, Marie.
I've been pissing off the edge of the porch.
Wait, why didn't you have plumbing? Because it froze? Like,
well,
she
actually
working.
Just likes to piss off the edge of the porch. Yeah. That has nothing to do
I
with
know.
The plumbing.
I know. Like it's weird. Her little pee hole. Like it always
hang my
jumps.
Ass over the edge of a railing.
It jumps. Usually it just goes down like a normal woman, but hers jumps. So
oh, no,
it's
no,
a fun
no.
fact.
No, nope. You hang your ass over the railing as if it were a toilet and then pee as you walk.
Wow.
However, there's a giant like old rusted tin thing right underneath me. So one time I was peeing and it hit the mustard the rusted metal, and it was like, brrr, and it scared the horses from across the pasture. All the horses came running because they were like, "What the fuck?" And I was like, "Sorry."
Wow, your piss scared some horses. That, you never thought you'd say that like a year ago.
Exactly. Exactly. You know, I'm.
But you're flexible. Good now. Did you run? Yeah. Did it just shut down and you just were?
Yeah, it was actually quite amazing because in New York, my old life, when it would snow, I'll never forget my first year living in New York City. I worked at Pulio's Italian Restaurant, 42nd and between 5th and Broadway.
We don't need the streets. We're good.
We worked
at an Italian restaurant.
I remember it was a snowstorm and I was like, okay, cool, it's snow. And then Mr. Pulio called and he's like, Marie, where are you? You're supposed to be here at 11. And I'm like, oh, I'm making a grilled cheese sandwich and tomato soup. It's a snowstorm. It's like, no, that was a good lesson that like you just continue on with life during a snowstorm in New York City.
The train will store. What's up, Bill?
The whole city shut down. And so I just cooked and masturbated, you know?
Yeah, I know.
I watched a lot of cool stuff. Yeah.
Did you read a book maybe cool or stuff. Just?
I did Discovery of Witches. I'm still working on the trilogy.
Oh, Discovery of Witches? What's up with that? It's a fantasy.
Oh, it's so good. It's fantasy. It's a witch. She's a witch. She fell in love with a vampire and they have to go back in time. It's so good. Anybody know these?
It's called, what's the name of the trilogy? Is it called Discovery of Witches?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that sounds like I saw an ad for it. I bet Jackie would be into that too. I bet Lexi would be into that too.
Well, the crazy thing is that I was reading the first book in Brooklyn, which is Discovery of Witches, and it's part of a trilogy. Yeah. And I'm walking down the street, and my book is in my bag. I was on Roebling and Bedford. Listen, this is the best human contact I've had in a while. Okay. No, but I just have the one book. And then I swear to God, I'm walking on the street and there are the two other books of the trilogy on the sidewalk. Like somebody had just left them out. And I was like, I am a witch.
Amazing.
Yeah. Isn't that crazy?
That's very cool. Especially now that the edibles are starting to kick in.
It is destiny. So my edibles are 35 milligrams, but I took half. Nice. But,
okay, I took a 10.
But I gave one of my friends who never does edibles the fifth 35 milligrams in Key West last year. He was running around the t-shirt shop saying, make it stop.
Yeah, you really don't want to go past 10 on a newbie, and even that's going to probably, like, 5 is really what you want to do.
My bad.
With a newbie.
I forget. I don't know. I don't know the milligrams, really. I just have always, like, tranquilized myself.
I think, Moosey Fates? Yeah, 35 milligrams on a new person? That'll do it.
That'll do it. They were, like, on an empty stomach, and probably, which is probably the case, because you guys are out and about, and, like, yada yada yada.
It was like
it'll just crush you. I mean, I love it. 100. I'm gonna feel it a lot. I'm gonna feel a lot of things.
I mean, that's when you're like your hands just like you're like. I mean, can you see the rainbows?
Mystery, thank you for the gift of sub to Parto Bond. You're a
Mystery,
man, baby.
Thanks.
In 2021. Also though, I will say I'm getting those. I also, when I go, so I get these little packs of pre-rolls. I'll get like sativa pre-rolls. I'll
That's
get the indica
love.
Pre-rolls, but then I'll also be like, now also give me a couple of them specials. And then they'll pull out these crazy things in a big tube and it's like one crazy one and it's like gonna, you know what I mean? And I had one of them so far, but yeah, you throw those in the mix.
But the big crazies are for sharing.
Well, aren't sadly, the cool thing is now you can get these little mini guys.
Right.
You can bring those to a party. Like I have a little pack of little guys and then you can, but everybody has, nobody doesn't have it. You know what I mean? Like sitting around.
Yeah, Julia was bragging. It's
cool,
she was like,
in LA, huh? Because everybody's
must be so fun.
Cool. And you got your party gifts like ready to roll.
Right.
How do you impress anybody? Do you bring like a cheese dip?
Like dabs.
No, vegan cheese.
Bring a dab.
Oh, sure.
Contraption.
A dab of. Oh.
What were you gonna wait? What were you about to say, Marie? About
Julia was Julia, bragging, yeah, like hanging out at Henry's, and he like rolled a joint for individually because it is a pandemic, so everybody got joints. So I was like, man, that sounds like so much fun.
Yeah, we did have a nice. I actually was there that night. It was very nice. We distance hang in his backyard, by the way. So so don't come at me, paparazzi. I know you're out there. I know you're outside of my apartment.
Well, okay. I have a fire pit. That's like, I haven't used it yet because of the snowstorm, awesome. But I'm pumped to invite people over for fire pit hangs.
Yeah. That was so sad. Do you have to say it sad like that? Do you have to say it like you're about to cry because no one's actually going to come over?
I have so many friends.
Is it a little bit better for you in Nashville compared to New York in terms of what's the improvement? That's what I was asking you earlier, Marie.
My quality of life is definitely way better.
Yeah, what's the improvement? Let's list it out. What was the move?
Hiking.
What was the great thing about moving from Brooklyn to Nashville? What are the improvements?
Okay. First floor. I live on the first floor. I can open the door, walk immediately out. I have a car. That's exciting.
I go hiking.
I actually try to walk every morning, try to get them 10,000 steps in. That doesn't happen, but there is like a little park near my house. I like that.
Hey, are you going to garden?
You know, can I show you something?
Yeah. Let me check.
I brought it up because I seem to remember an inkling of gardening.
Very nice.
Is this Deb?
Oh.
Well, no. It's definitely not dead.
Is Floam still in chat as well? Because, of course, Carly and Floam do the plant chat. You'll be better at promoting that.
We do a show called Dig It on Wednesdays, and I've gotten very much into plants since I've got here. No, that plant looks pretty happy. What's the problem?
It's getting real dry in the bottom.
But
I don't know.
Also, it's
thriving. So here's a good question. I had it in the bathroom with no windows.
I would say put it in some sun.
Okay.
Give it some water, but then let the dirt completely dry out.
Yeah.
Completely dry out.
Oh, yeah.
Any more water because
you don't keep it moist.
Well, that is the mistake that I've made many times where you want to overwater. Not this time of year. This time of year, especially, plants are kind of hibernating, but they do need sun.
Wow.
So it's not going to like bloom in front of your eyes this time of year either. It's not the season for it to really prosper. You're just looking to keep it happy, watered, which it looks like it's pretty strong.
It's okay.
Also, I will say you can sing to the plant. That'll make it happy. But don't masturbate in the apartment because that makes the plant sad.
The plant feels like
you should be, you know, dating.
I gotta water it.
Yeah. With waxy leaves. Yes. Don't overwater. I couldn't quite see from your picture, like, what. Do you know what plant that is? I couldn't quite
see. No. I don't know. I just like the pink thing. I like the pink. And then I was like, oh, shit, there's a plant in this.
Yeah, but you give that plant some sun and it will flourish.
Now that's when it starts to
become spring, give it a little bit of food. And then that was amazing. No, plant food is amazing. You give it to them so rarely. And like I've got African violets and I gave them some plant food in the winter still. And they just like lose their minds and go bloom all over the place.
Sometimes plants act like little plant bastards. So honestly, if it's making you upset, throw it out the window and forget about it.
Okay.
There you go.
That's
the plant man himself. Holden, do you have a single plant?
I would like to say the balcony, which is, if I open that window right there, it's behind me. It has a ton of hooks on the ceiling, and I want to deck it out and get a bunch of hanging plants out there.
Nice.
It's not on the top of my list, but
philodendron. Get one philodendron. You can do cuts, and they'll be nice little hanging canopies.
Yes,
and
that's what I want.
Each of those cuts can make a new plant. They're very easy
to raise.
Poison
ivy's fucking
nothing.
Lair out there, and I just want to make it as cozy as possible because I go out there obviously to smoke, but also to read and relax.
So awesome balcony.
I just love having it. It's like my little, and it's a little, especially right now. It's a little too chilly for Lexi, so it is kind of my little personal space right now.
I
love it. I go sit out there and read for hours, and just I'm so happy that I just have immediate access to fresh air. And it's not like
that's how I feel in
Astoria. It's like you would walk outside, but there would be a person at least every block, at least one person. So you never really felt comfortable not wearing the mask if you wanted to like not be a jerk, You know what I mean? And mm-hmm. so it's just so much better to like, and especially this, having my own personal space that's just fresh air. That's just, yeah. It's just,
well, it's funny. There's this super fancy grocery store around the corner from my house. And I can walk to it. And everyone keeps being like, oh my God, did you go there and spend a fortune? And I'm like, this is nothing compared to what I spent in New York on groceries.
Right.
Like my shitty ass grocery store in Fort Greene was so expensive. So like $6.99 for chips, you know,
and a soup.
Ridiculous.
Yeah.
And so I mean,
cans of soup I would get that were $6. I mean, they were good soups, but they were still a can of fucking soup.
My jobs have improved. Like I was I had 10 jobs 2 years ago. Like remember I worked at a bar on fucking Governor's Island. I had to take a boat to work. I don't have to take a boat to work.
Yeah. There was also that guy always on the corner who was like, free apple juice. You'd be like, free. And you take a sip. It was his piss. It was disgusting.
Yeah,
like,
you guys.
Can we just be humans on the planet? Can we just offer
here they have
something
Hawaiian punch.
I will say the a little more aggressive. I'm going to say the homeless community out here a little bit more of an edge. The LA version.
That's true. Well, I would go visit my sister who's in San Francisco, and that was the same deal. Obviously there were plenty of homeless people in New York, which I was always very torn about because when I first came to New York, I had a lot of friends who were homeless. In college, I went and did like the rainbow gatherings and stuff. So I was completely torn about like how to handle it. And then after, you know, a handful of occasions, I said, okay, well, what's safe and what isn't safe? And I stopped hanging out with homeless folks for 45 minutes to an hour.
Also, Moosey says, get a hanging nature plant. Because the summer going to have more flies than you ever imagined coming from East Coast. Interesting.
Oh, it's a different thing in California, though, which is what I was getting at. And that if you say, sorry, I can't help you, they will still follow you down the block and, you know, a little more intensity. It's – I don't know how to deal with it well. But
so we're getting towards the
– you'll figure that out.
We're getting towards the third hour here. Marie, did you want to stick around and play Jackbox? Or you,
I'd love to.
Awesome.
This gummy's going to kick in, so this will be.
I know, right? I might have, I might even do another one in a little bit. But either way, also, I think Lexi might join us as well.
Oh, yay.
So that should be a lot of fun. Also, somebody needs to sing Tequila. And who would like to do that for us? One of my
Carly.
Carly, you want to do it?
Do you guys know that Tequila is a joke karaoke,
yes,
right?
Yes, I do know this.
Okay,
But thank you for explaining it so that it takes all wind out of it, potentially being a surprise for anyone.
Well, I'm just saying any of us are certainly capable, but I'll own it.
All right.
Just my thesis real quick. I'm way happier here. I really think that this has been a good move, and who knows if I'll stay, but I'm close with my family. I'm riding like crazy.
Great.
You look very bright.
Yeah.
I haven't drank actually in 8 days because I was a raging alcoholic there for a while. First week I lived here, I was drinking a bottle a night and I was like, okay, I'm glad
two
I had
for
this.
Me. But yes, I'm also trying not to drink during the week, which is a lot easier now because I go to bed a lot earlier and Lexi can't
it's
drink.
It's so fun. I really like to drink.
Yeah, me too. But I'm fine with it. And honestly, it makes such a big difference in terms of just operationally during the week.
Yeah.
Like you wake up when you should. I mean, hey, how about those first couple nights sleep though? Those are fuckers, huh?
Yeah, they really are.
You don't get much sleep. And then when you do sleep, your dreams are horrendous.
Wake up and you're still in the dream because it's a pandemic.
Oh man, I've been having crazy dreams recently. Which
but
is
I have
strange
been dating
because
this.
I never remember dreams.
I have been dating this guy, you guys.
Yeah.
So, I did break up with that guy that I brought to your wedding. I told you about that. I'm so sorry.
I gave him a book, or my father.
Yes, your father did. I know. But this guy would actually be really fun to hang because he's. I'm not going to say the movies he's been in, but if I told you, and he was on True Blood for a long time.
Really?
So he's like does some stuff. Yeah,
Is he like True Blood jacked?
Jacked?
Like jacked, like ripped, like, shredded?
He is ripped. Yeah, he's a big ripped guy. Yeah.
Does he have a six pack?
No, he's work. I mean, he, yeah, maybe. I don't know. He's pretty cute.
Do you just climb him like a tree?
Well, I was there, but then once he booked this next TV show, we have to quarantine from each other because he can't get COVID. Because then, anyway, it's been the biggest like blue balls of my life.
That's so annoying. And then what if he meets some fucking bitch on this?
Oh, he will. He will. He will. That's my luck.
I am. I am happy for Marie. Are you kidding me? Yeah, I'm squeaking. That's awesome.
He's great.
Have you been to the Taylor Swift Museum in Nashville?
Yes, I have. It's amazing.
It's amazing. I want to come visit so bad for more than just that reason, but definitely that reason. Also, I forgot to mention this. I forgot to mention this, Marie, and this is something that I couldn't talk about out loud back when it happened, but I want to just throw it out there. In literally like a 2-day span, I found out Lexi was pregnant. Oh. I went Twitch partner, and Taylor Swift surprise dropped Evermore. Literally in... I was literally just like, what is happening? Like, it was one of those weird... I know one of those things is not like the other.
It came in three, though.
But it came in this package of like, what is happening right now? Like, it wasn't even a week. It was like a 2-day span. All of that.
Now you will never listen to Evermore without thinking of like just being like so happy and giddy. I went on immediately and ordered, well, I think I texted you about it, but I ordered some merch and then all her vinyl for Fearless.
Nice.
It's so good. All those new songs. I mean, all the old new songs. I know. It sounds exactly the same.
It sounds pretty much the same. Her voice has matured a little bit. So her voice, but I wouldn't want it to sound.
Oh, she sounds so much better. Yeah, she sounds incredible.
I wouldn't want it to sound different too much.
Yeah, I know. But I'm so excited for her, and I think that... I just want to support her.
Oh. I want to wear her skin. I want to be her.
Wait, but so you did say that you ordered merch and you never got it from her.
I got an update. And anyways, I needed to change my address. But anyways, I guess what I got is maybe like a sweatshirt with her face on it. But it's like, Lexi was like, I think it's like a belly sweatshirt. So I like can't even necessarily wear it. And I got another toboggan that says Taylor Swift on it. Another like little hat.
You got a crop sweatshirt.
I may have gotten a crop sweatshirt, but I might wear it sometimes. I'll just kind of dance around like this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so LA.
As Lexi gets more preggers, I mean, the two of you should take turns with the sweatshirt and just show off your belly.
I love it. She's getting thick with child, ladies.
Oh my God. I don't know how I'd feel about having an alien grow inside.
Isn't that crazy?
Marie, we could talk about this. Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, are you on the fence, Carly? Are you gonna...
Well, I mean, I...
What's your 5-year plan?
I don't know. I've always been weird about it, to be honest, in that I've never really wanted to be pregnant. I don't really want to be pregnant. I don't want to.
Yeah.
I personally am...
Yeah, I don't want to blow out my badge, you know?
I mean, it's like some of that, but it also comes down, like, there's a lot of adoption in my family, and I've always thought, like, well, you know what, if I reach that point where I really want a kiddo and it's not, you know, it's not working with my body, I will adopt, because adoption is beautiful, and it's like, it has to do with just, the respect for it, and there are kids that
need. My sister's adopted. They adopted her the day she was born because they couldn't have children. They were told, never will your loins make a child. And then I popped out.
That's always what happens. Funny. That's literally always what happens. Like, I want to tell every couple who's struggling with that, just adopt, and then like you'll be immediately cursed with an actual child.
Yeah, you're like triplets.
Yeah. Exactly.
I am happy. I mean, I do like it's nice that here, you know, there are lots of kids and they're all between like 1 and 5. So whether they're family kids or they're friends of family kids, and we're not seeing each other because of COVID, which is sad. But like I love all of those kids so much, and I love having them in my life, and it's not so much a concern for me, like, is it mine? But you know,
sing tequila, future mom.
I love this from Reagan Piper Rose. Being pregnant was awesome for me. Mine was 6 weeks early and small, but I pee when I sneeze now. So isn't that fun? All right, if you want to,
I do think it's a miracle. Women are way cooler than men because we can birth.
Yeah, I was 6 weeks early.
Me too, actually.
No way.
You do this.
Were your lungs developed?
I'm gonna go grab a soda really quick and tell Lexi That's about cool. Jackbox. I'll
I didn't right back.
Okay.
Well, they weren't inflated. Hopefully you can hear that all right.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, cool.
I like dancing like a Muppet. Olive!
Tequila.
Yeah.
Tequila.
Woo!
Very good.
That was hot.
Awesome. We did it. But we didn't do it because we have another hour of fun. We're going to play Jackbox now.
What does it mean to get verified on Twitch?
Going like partner.
Partner, yeah. So, you get like some stock.
It's yeah. It's like you get little benefits, like I get ad revenue now. I think you get some before, but I get more ad revenue now. You get better support from Twitch themselves. Wow. Mainly, it's a status thing in a big way. It's mainly just saying, like, to me, it was kind of like, I felt like more so than before, I could say, I am a professional Twitch streamer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, right. I have been verified by Twitch as, like, a leader of a community to be, you know, GoPro, whatever, right? Like,
wow.
I felt like a little semi-pro before, right?
Right. Now it's official.
So, and that's all. And not to say that, like, not being verified as partner makes you, like, delegitimizes you. But it just is that extra little oomph. And for me personally, I never get accepted in this way ever. Like, authority hates my guts. I've always felt that way. Yada, yada, yada. You know, and well, you get a subscription button, actually.